Good evening, students. Today we are going to see an important writing skill activity, that is notice writing. This will appear from question number 37 to 40. Either it may appear in question number 37, 38 or 39 or 40. So under these section, you will be given different types of question. Verbal and non-verbal comprehension might be given. Dialogue writing might be given. Giving instruction, describing a process, completion of a proverb, notice writing, article writing, expansion of headlines, email writing, unscramble the sentences. Out of these questions, notice writing is a very important question. So we'll be discussing the other topics in the subsequent videos that we are going to see. So this is a 3 marks question, and now we'll see how to write a notice. So first of all, let me give you what is the notice. A notice is a written or printed announcement. Example, a notice for sale. So this might be a notice. It is written in order to inform a large number of people about something that has happened or is about to happen. It is generally written in a formal tone. Notices are factual and to the point. So you have to keep in mind the meaning of what is the notice. It is a written announcement, printed announcement. So it might be anything. It might not only be about sale, it might be something which is of ownership of a property or transfer of ownership to some other person, or birth details or death details might even be given as a notice. So it is written in order to inform a large number of people. So that you have to keep in mind. So it is to inform a large number of people about something that has happened, so which has already happened or that is going to happen in future. So it is generally in a formal tone. It is not going to exaggerate anything. Notices are usually factual. Factual means it is going to give only facts and no other exaggerated points will be given. So steps to be followed in notice writing. Number one, name of the issuing agency, that is school, colleges, hospital, etc., whatever the issuing authority or agency is, that is the name of the issuing agency. The second one is date of issue or release of the notice. That is also very important. You have to give the date on which the notice is being published. Then the third one is title, subject of the event or what it is stating. Example, you may say a sports day. It might be about a sports notice that is informing the sports day that is going to take place in a school, or an annual day celebration that is going to take place in a school, or a kabaddi competition that is going to be held in your town, anything it might be. So fourth one is body, date, time, duration, place, venue, when and where. So that is the fourth information. Body of the notice contains the date, time, duration, place, venue of where the activity is going to be held. The fifth one is authorized signatory, name and signature, or the contact details will be given. That is, the person who is giving the notice is the authorized signatory. So below that is given a format. You can see that this is the format of the notice, that you have name of the issuing agency authority and block letters. You have to note down that there is a capital letters, it is inscribed there, it is written in capital letters, notice, then date of the issue, release of the new notice. Then you have to give the title, subject of the event, and the body of the notice is that you have to give the date, time, duration, place and venue. And you might have seen that all these content are inscribed within a box. That is very, very important in notice writing. So next is example question number one. That is, Janata Group Housing Society announces all the residents regarding the suspension of water supply. So that is the announcement that is given by Janata Group Housing Society. So what it is announcing? It is announcing that suspension of water supply will be there in the housing board. So let us see the example. So who is the giving authority? Is Janata Group Housing Society, Palam, Bihar, Kurnool. Notice. So that is taken to the margin, but you can even write it in the center. There is no wrong in doing that. Then you have got the date, see that, March 1, 2010. So attention. So in order to grasp the attention of the viewers or the readers, that word is given there. This notice is to inform all the residents regarding the suspension of water supply for 8 hours. So that is the fact that they are giving. It is being done to clean the water tank. So what is the reason for doing that? They also mentioned that. The details are all as follows. Date March 6, time 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Thus, we request you to store the required amount of water beforehand to minimize the difficulty. So what is the reason of giving the notice is they wanted to reduce the inconvenience to the residents there. So they are asking the residents to store sufficient amount of water so that they will be not they will not be facing any problem for the 2 days. So thank you, Karan or Karan Kumar or Karuna Bajaj. So that is the signature of the person who is giving the notice there, secretary. So he is holding the post of the secretary there. So again, I'll read out the content there. This notice is to inform all the residents regarding the suspension of water supply for 8 hours. It is being done to clean the water tank. The details are as follows. Date March 6, time 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. Thus, we request you to store the required amount of water beforehand to minimize the difficulty. Thank you. Karan Kumar, Karuna Bajaj, signature secretary. So we'll see another example there. This is notice writing on lost and found goods. Question number 2. While walking in a park in your neighborhood, you found a small plastic bag containing some documents and some cash. Write a notice in about 50 words to be put on the park notice board asking the owner to identify and collect it from you. You are Amar or Amrita. So they have also given you the phone number there. This is a CBSE question 2017. So you can, this is also asked in our board also, you can just note it down. So here you could see that it is being inscribed within a box and the word notice is taken to the margin. But yeah, I told you already, it can also be written in the center. So March 1st, 2020, found. This is to inform all the readers that a plastic bag has been found in the neighborhood park. It has a few documents and some cash in it. The plastic bag is red in color and is medium sized. It was found on February 27 at around 6 p.m. near the fountain in the park. The owner of the bag shall contact me on 9399123456 along with an identity proof. Thank you, Amar Amrita. So these are the people, they are giving the notice there. And you could see the content is very clear and it gives all the details about the bag. It contains the identification marks has to be given and when it was found and what are the contents in it. Everything is clearly given and the contact number is also given. So this is how you have to write a notice. So the notice has to be very clear to the readers so that they are not confused. So now we'll see the points to remember while writing a notice. Always enclose the notice in a box. So I told you already, it has to be written only within a box. Make sure you draw the box with a pencil and a scale. Keep your notice short, crisp and to the point. It has to be short. It should not be elaborately written. Highlight the word notice and the title. It can be either bold or underlined. So you can write it in bold letters, capital letters, or it can be underline. The title should be captivating and eye-catching. The title should be attractive so that it gets the attention of the readers. Don't make hypothetical information and facts. Make use of what's given in the question. So you should not exaggerate over thing. You have to take the correct contents which are given in the question. So that is one of the advantages that you can do in this question. You can easily get 3 marks from this question. Make sure you do not mention your personal information. That is very, very important. Make use of all the available information in the question. Your answer shall include answers to all the 5 W's. That is what, why, when, where, and who. So your questions, all these WH questions should be answered while writing your notice. So these are the points that you have to remember while writing a notice. Thank you, students. We'll see in another video clipping for another question. Thank you.